Good. So now we've done the basic strength movement, the pressing exercise with the enhanced range of motion. The next one, while for your set, will be, we'll start the isolation work. So it's gonna be front delt work. So you've done this before, front raise with the kettlebell, then same weight overhead, and the same weight cheated front raise between your legs. What I really like about the kettlebell press like this, put the hand in a natural position like you're when you're running stuff. Like this, we can increase the range of motion safely. The ranging motion, it's right to increase the range of motion, putting your elbows out, puts you in a really dangerous position. But here, it's your body is mechanically suited to be here. So you have a greater range of motion, shoulder works does more without injuring it, endangering it. The goal of the press is also to increase the range of motion. So bringing your elbow here and you press it, trying to bring your biceps through here. Really increase range of motion. But we start with leaning away laterals first. Ooh. Your shoulder workout and 7 scoop of workout fuel and 2 finger bars is not a good mix. It's really painful.
Transform the shirt into a size larger.
Good.
when it comes to isolation movement, just because I'm really efficient at activating the muscles, I don't have to use heavy weights. Actually, I can't use heavy weights because even with a lighter weight, I can fully contract the muscles and fatigue them really, really fast. Now, people think, well, it's just lifting weights, lift for strength. No. Isolation movements serve the purpose of constant tension on the muscle and localized fatigue. If you have to cheat, you'll use other muscle groups, and the target muscle group will not get fully stimulated. Oof.